Production of this program has been made possible in part by a grant from the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and the Southern Educational Communications Association.
Central Alabama Music Park in Jemison, Alabama, Alabama Jubilee. Tonight, the man who gave bluegrass its name, Bill Monroe and the Bluegrass Boys. And from the Appalachian Mountains of Southwest Virginia, the lost and found.
We're glad to be here with you folks today, and I think you've had a wonderful show here already. I think everything has really been fine. The Bluegrass Cardinals really sounded good. Dale McCurry, you couldn't beat that fellow, man. He's a wonderful lead singer. He used to be a bluegrass boy. Mac Wiseman, this is a fine show. I'm glad to be a part of it. We have a new member in the Bluegrass Boys on the left-hand side here now, and he's from the state of Ohio and a fine guitar man, and he can really sing. His name is Tommy Ewan. Would you give him a hand? And this right here, he's from around Nashville, Tennessee, and he's played bass fiddle with a lot of people like Lester Flatt, like that, and we're glad he's here with us today. His name is Johnny Montgomery. Would you give him a hand? That right there is a Sparta player, Sparta, Tennessee.
Yes, sir.
And he's a hard-driving banjo picker. His name is Blake Williams. Would you give him a hand? That old gentleman there, he's from the state of Virginia. And he played for me, I guess, probably 60 or 70 years ago. And his name is Tater, 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 Tate. Give him a hand. This gentleman's going to sing for you now. And he's got an old-timer picked out entitled Blackjack Davy.
Blackjack David came riding through the woods and sang so loud and gay. Broke the hearts of many poor girls and he charmed the heart of a lady, charmed the heart of a lady. Little miss, how old are you, my honey? She answered him with a silly smile. I'll be 16 next Sunday. I'll be 16 next Sunday. Come go with me, my pretty little miss. Go with me, my honey. I'll take you where the grass grows. And you never shall want for money. You never shall want for money. Last night she slept on a goose feather bed beside her husband and baby. Tonight she sleeps on the cold, cold ground by the side of Blackjack Davy, beside of Blackjack Davy. Davy came right through the woods, sang so loud and gay. Broke the hearts of many poor girls and it charmed the heart of a lady, charmed the heart of a lady.
All right, that's fine. That's a good song right there. Now we're going to call on this old gentleman here with the five-string banjo. And he's going to do an old southern number titled Dear Old Dixie. Blake Williams. Been sleeping up a storm, that's what has helped you. I'd like to sing a couple of songs. You might not think that I know the words to them, but I do. Here's the first one. It's the first one I ever sung on the Grand Ole Opry, The Mules Can Blues. Thank you. if you don't like your job. This number I want to do for you is for all you folks that's here today. It's entitled Blue Moon of Kentucky. Keep on shining. And make them have to get in there and work, and they're going to have to work to play this number here.
Uh-oh.
It's entitled Come Hither to Go Yonder. Thank you. I tried hard. It's time for the Bluegrass Quartet to sing for you folks here today. And we'd like to do a number that we think is really a wonderful number entitled The Boat of Love.
Boat of love down at the harbor, it's waiting fast for you and me. I have no fear, Christ is the captain.
You got a soul,
I soul and see.
And sail a sea,
and sail a sea, home above, home above.
Don't wait too late,
don't wait too late.
Make your reservations,
make reservations.
It's the boat of God,
it's the boat of God's
eternal love.
Oh, the boat of love down at the harbor,
down at the harbor.
It's waiting fast
for you and me,
for you and me. I hope to fear, Christ is the captain.
Christ is the captain. You got a soul,
you got a soul, I throw and see.
For the boat of love, soon be sailing,
we'll soon be sailing.
It's heading for. Heaven is my home,
heaven is my home
forevermore.
Oh, the boat of love down at the harbor,
down at the harbor.
It's waiting fast
for you and me.
I have no fear, Christ is the captain.
Christ is the captain. You got a soul.
To a real old lady from the state of Florida, Lizzie Lewis. And there's another lady here named Wanda Huff. We want to do that for her. We hope you ladies like that. Was it all right? You enjoy it? All right, it's time for some fiddle music now, so we're going to call on old Tater Tate here to fiddle one for us. And this number was wrote in the state of Indiana, up at Bean Blossom, Indiana, where we have our festivals. And we was getting ready to go on the stage. And I put this number together right quick. It's entitled The Old Brown County Jamboree Barn.
Excuse me, just a minute, Mr. Monroe. We've got an award, a certificate of appreciation from the governor of Alabama we'd like to present you at this time.
All right, sir.
Mr. Bill, this is in observance of your 50 years in show business. This certificate of appreciation from Governor Jordan C. Wallace, the governor of the great state of Alabama.
Boy, you couldn't beat that. I've been on Governor Wallace's side all the way. I really pulled for him when he went through some bad things. And for this him to send this to Bill Monroe, I'm really honored here today. From the state of Alabama, when it's springtime in old Alabama.
You want to show it to him? Turn around and show it to him there.
Look at that.
Isn't
that
nice?
Isn't that nice? Yeah, that's nice. That is fine. I will keep that.
Also, Governor Wallace asked us to present this autographed photo of himself to you, because he couldn't make it here this weekend. That's nice.
Well, I really appreciate this. And this is going to go out to the Bluegrass Hall of Fame out at Music Village, USA. And a lot of people from different states all over the country have sent us things. And, of course, the presidents, they've sent us pictures down there, and we appreciate all that. But to get this from Governor Wallace, I'm really proud of this. He's a wonderful man, and let's all pull for him all the way. I'm so glad he sent this.
Thank you.
You couldn't beat that. Boy, this has made my day right here, boy. How did you like that fiddle number that old Tater played? Boy, he was so good along, man. He had the fiddle. There wasn't no way around it. All right, let's see now. We're gonna field some questions a little bit later on, but right now we have a number coming up here that we really love this number here. Lester Flatt wrote this back when he worked with me, entitled The Little Cabin Home on the Hill.
To our little cabin home on the hill.
Alabama Jubilee will continue shortly with more music from the Central Alabama Music Park. We'd like to pause here to invite your comments about our program. Write us in care of Alabama Jubilee, Post Office Box X, the University of Alabama, Tuscaloosa, Alabama, 35487.
Side of the mountain where the rippling waters flow. You made me and so I'll be waiting on the hillside for the day you to call on the sunny side of the mountain where the rippling waters fall. On. Don't forget me, little darling, though our love affair seems gone. Wonder if you lonesome too. Wonder if you lonesome too.
Well, I don't want you to cry cause of me. Don't want you to cry cause of me. Only my thoughts make you lonesome. Wonder if you lonesome too. Will you be lonesome too?
How would you like to be lonesome when someone is through with you? My heart is set and it's lonesome. Wonder if you lonesome too. Wonder if you lonesome too.
Wonder if you lonesome too. Will you be lonesome?
wonder if you're lonesome too. Sing this farewell to you. Oh, I'll be so lonesome without you. Wonder if you're lonesome too. Will you be lonesome? How would you like to be lonesome when someone is through with you? My heart is sad and it's lonesome. Wonder if you're lonesome too. Wonder if you're lonesome too.
Lord, we've waited here so long, singing praises, singing songs, waiting for the happy day that you'll return. When we hear the trumpet blast, we will welcome you at last and go back with you to the throne of God.
Come on down, Lord, and gather in your fold.
Come on down,
like the shepherd in the glorious days of old.
Come on down,
come and get your children, don't be slow. Weary in this wicked world we know.
Over on the other side, we will all be satisfied. A home he promised on the other shore. There will be with our Father up above, in his mansion we will live forevermore.
Come on down,
come on down, Lord, and gather in your fold.
Come on down,
like the shepherd in the glorious days of old.
Come on down,
come and get your children, don't be slow. Weary in this wicked world we know. Shepherd in the glorious days of old.
Come on down,
come and get your children, don't be slow. Weary in this wicked world below.
Oh, I thank y'all a whole bunch. We got a bunch of things we want to do for it. Got a new album that we've been proud of, and gracious knows Steve Wilson really, I think, added to this particular album, too. We did a song in it that we like pretty much, and Steve gets to sing it. I want you to say hello to him, make him welcome now while we do the Rodeo Cowboy. How about it?
Well, it really has been nice being with you. I've got to leave. As you know, I'm a rodeo cowboy, and there's a rodeo down in Mesquite. That's the
life of a rodeo cowboy.
Breaking broncs or getting broke. That's the
life of a rodeo cowboy, and that's the only life I know.
Think today is the big one, and I'm walking away with all that they own. Yet you're lying, hurting, hearing someone say it. Give him a hand, that's all that cowboy's taking home. Hot beer and cold stale hamburgers make a meal sort of hard to enjoy. And it kind of makes you think of your mama's chicken. But that's the life of a rodeo cowboy. That's the
life of a rodeo cowboy.
Breaking Bronx are getting broke. That's the
life of a rodeo cowboy, and that's the only life I know.
Thank you all a bunch. Appreciate it. The man that rode Home Sweet Home never was a married man.
Actually, Daddy was the one that had the record. Mama didn't. She would have broke it.
Don't tell it.
One, two, three.
The man that rode Home Sweet Home never was a married man. He never had no loving wife to beat him with a frying pan.
She'll meet you at the door when you start to come in, then knock you down with a rolling pin.
And the man that rode Home Sweet Home never was a married man.
A man gets up early in the morning, leaves his wife in bed. She lies there, the kids wake up and cry, get up and cook some bread. Now let me tell you a thing or two, a woman like that will never do. And the man that rode Home Sweet Home couldn't have been a married man. Then a man comes home at dinner time, hungry and he wants to eat. But he finds his wife piled up in the bed and can't get her on her feet. Sometimes it's more than a man can bear, and even enough to make him swear that the man that rode Home Sweet Home never was a married man.
The man that rode Home Sweet Home never was a married man. He never had no loving wife to beat him with a frying pan.
She'll meet you at the door when you start to come in and knock you down with that rolling pin.
And the man that rode Home Sweet Home never was a married man.
Then a man comes home from work at night, tired, and he has a drink. And he can't find his wife nowhere around, so then he begins to think, this kind of life starts me to wishing that I could be off somewhere fishing, or something like that. 'Cause the man that rode Home Sweet Home never was a married man.
The man that rode Home Sweet Home never was a married man. He never had no loving wife to beat him with a frying pan.
She'll meet you at the door when you start to come in and knock you down with a rolling pin.
And the man that rode Home Sweet Home never was a married man.
He could not be.
The man that rode Home Sweet Home never was a married man.
Uh-uh.
The man that rode Home Sweet Home never was a married man.
I tell you what, fellas, let's dedicate that to J.C. and Debbie, Calvin Free and Freddie's daughter and son-in-law that's over in Louisiana that's going to catch the show here pretty soon, and we'll do that just for them. And appreciate Calvin and them letting us know about it, and Teresa for coming over to visit with us from over around Farmersville, Louisiana. And that reminded me about the fishing, because we get to fish in Lake Darbonne when we over vacation a little bit of time. In 1975, we did the first album we told you about earlier today, and I had written a song about the home place where my great-grandparents raised my mother many, many years ago. And Granddaddy come to live with us when I was just very small and left a lot of memories in my life, and I put some of them together in song. And this is one that I hope you'll enjoy. It's titled Love of the Mountains. Trees on the hillside of the mountain, always looking up towards the sky, remind me of my papa and my mama, who lived there 80 years before they died. Now a bright moon is shining in the valley, An old wagon leans against a stack of hay. Two graves on a hillside by a cabin. My mom and dad are resting there today. The sizzle of the greenwood on a fireplace, the falling snow around the redbud tree, the branches of the laurels by the creek bed, and the rippling waters of the gentle stream. Papa used to talk about the young days when he and Mama first were settled there. He spoke about the love of the mountains that he and Mama shared together there. Now a bright moon is shining in the valley. An old wagon leans against a stack of hay. Two graves on a hillside by a cabin. My mom and dad are resting there today. Shining in the valley, an old wagon leans against a stack of hay. Two graves on a hillside by a cabin. My mom and dad are resting there today. Oh boy, on time. Do a tune that was a novelty thing for us, and our first guitar player we had was named Roger Handy. Had a brother that in the years of probably about 1978 and 9, when he left home, we tied a string on him so he could find his way back. I didn't want the boy to get lost. But he'd written a couple of songs that he let us record, and they've been some pretty good ones, and we enjoyed a bunch. And I always like to do this for the ladies, because you men folks, when you go off in the house, you know, when you get back, it don't take you but just a little while to find out if you've been gone too long. Said Bertie Sullivan wanted to hear this. Did Newell come with her? If he didn't, he'll eat biscuits, I guess. We want to do this for them and all you folks who like this particular song, Leftover Biscuits.
Leftover biscuits, leftover ham, leftover gravy in an old frying pan, leftover coffee, leftover tea. Now I'm all alone, 'cause she's done left over me.
Well, I asked my wife if I could go out with the boys, just a little party over at Jimmy Roy's. She said, yeah, honey, you know that I don't care. What I did not tell her, it was a three-day affair.
Leftover biscuits, leftover ham, leftover gravy in an old frying pan, leftover coffee, leftover tea. Now I'm all alone, 'cause she's done leftover me.
Then we went to this party over at the neighbor's home. Me and the neighbor's wife in the kitchen all alone. I could have said something else. She was making biscuits while I was making time. Caught in the act by that little old wife of mine.
Leftover biscuits, leftover ham, leftover gravy in an old frying pan, leftover coffee, leftover tea. Now I'm all alone, 'cause she's done left over me. Now I'm all alone, 'cause she's done left over me.
cowboy. We got a couple of more things we want to do, and then we'll get out of your hair. And gracious, I've got a request for a tune that's in our Sun's Gonna Shine album. We were up in Washington, D.C., doing a double show with a country gentleman at the world-famous Birchmere Restaurant, where the country gentleman hangs out every Thursday night, sometimes when the seldom scene's gone. If a seldom scene's there, they run them out of town. But we go up and work occasionally in the winter months and have a great time. Steve was in the bus, and he said, I got a song I want you guys to listen to. It sounded great. We got in the studio about Tuesday, recorded it, and we've been trying to learn it ever since. But I think it's a great piece of material, and we had some requests for it. It's called Colder and Colder.
This is for Larry and Jan, especially for Jan.
Since I was 13, and now at 28, there's not too much I haven't seen. But I'd trade it all tomorrow if I could only find the one that tore my world apart, that loving girl of mine. It's getting colder and colder in this old house all alone,
'cause without no one to love, this house ain't much of a home.
I'm falling deeper and deeper into a world of despair,
'cause the next time that I come home, I know she won't be waiting there.
One night to let her know when I'd be home. It was then she told me by the time I got there she'd be gone. I guess I've stayed away from home too many nights with the band, never once suspecting that her love was slipping through my hands. It's getting colder and colder in this old house all alone,
'cause without no one to love, this house ain't much of a home.
I'm falling deeper and deeper into a world of despair,
'cause the next time that I come home, I know she won't be waiting there.
Listen to them boys while they play the Golden Slippers. Thank you. Thank y'all.
That's Webster.
Austin Bound, everyone.
Thank you, Chuck. Appreciate it.
Oh. Gotta do it over, Alvin.
Thank you, Bob Wills lovers.
Production of this program has been made possible in part by a grant from the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and the Southern Educational Communications Association.